I have finally figured out what is wrong with their stupid little planeswalker story that the splash art is telling us about.
What's wrong with their planeswalker story that the splash art is telling us about?
There's no planeswalker captain planet.
Well,
fire! Earth! Brain! Whip! Your powers combined! I'm Captain Zendikar! And then, like, he comes up and beats up Pollution, a.k.a. Eldrazi.
Oh, right. The Eldrazi are just a metaphor, you see.
Yeah. Yeah, I've seen Fern Gully.
Yeah, yeah. Basically anyways, the same thing.
So what are we doing tonight, Jens?
Well, tonight is the... So they've been doing these, like, flashback drafts.
Yeah, whole year of Modern, I believe.
And tonight is the last night for the full Mirrodin Block one.
Ah, that being Mirrodin, Darksteel, and Fifth Dawn, right?
Yes. Mirrodist, and Fivedin.
Mirrodisfidon.
Yeah, Mirrodisfidon. That's a card, right?
There's Histrodon. But not Mirrodisfidon, I don't think. Yeah. But,
So I didn't play the Mirrodin Darksteel one because I didn't think it would be entirely compelling difference. Though it is a different.
It is different.
You don't have
Scry.
Well, I mean more from like the Triple Mirrodin.
Oh, it's different from that, but only one third different. But that can be a huge change.
Yeah, it's enough.
MD5 draft, not to be confused with the checksum. Yeah. Kavanaugh, we were thinking of you when we named the stream.
It's true. I was trying to fit both Sunburst and Converge in there, but I just gave up.
Yeah, we gave up.
I gave up after like 2 minutes.
See,
logical, that was like the first thing that entered my head, and there was no way I was naming the stream that, so I just gave up.
See, the problem is, we gave up on Converge as quickly as the developers did.
Oh no.
Oh no.
So
good luck making Converge work with your two packs of Oath of the Gatewatch, friends.
Oh. Yeah, okay. So I played at a so I've been drafting at my local shop pretty like sort of regularly. And in Battle for Zendikar, I've basically only drafted one deck at the shop.
Yeah. Ever.
It's Blue White Awaken every time.
Blue White Awaken, yeah.
Sometimes it splashes a third color, sometimes it doesn't. Most of the time it doesn't. I just splashed black once.
So you just pick every blue and white Awaken card in pack 3?
Well, no, I went there on Friday last week, and I posted the little screenshot. I posted the picture I took of it. I first picked a Reflector Mage over, like, Tyrant of Valakut, because fuck that.
Reflector Mage is such a good mono war.
So I was like, okay, I'll just be in blue-white. And so pack 3 rolls around, and I pick in succession Sheer Drop, Halimar Awakener, or Halimar, like, Wave Caller, and Royal Spout. And I'm just like, Blue-White Awaken is real.
It's real, as it turns out. How many Shatter are we first picking? Probably at least one. We can't pick first. I guess we can't first pick more than one Shatter. We can pick multiples, but I don't recall how good like artifact removal in the other packs is, actually. I remember little about the full block. Yeah,
there's a lot of stuff around.
There is.
Yeah, so Halimar Tidecaller is the name. Yeah, whatever. Halimar, look, here's the thing about Halimar Tidecaller, and this has been true every time I've played the deck in Limited. Nobody knows what that card actually does. Nobody reads the second line of text that gives your lands flying.
It gives your lands flying, so you have 3/3 hasters coming out of your butt.
Nobody reads that.
Nobody reads it. Nobody.
It's a cool line of text.
It is. The card is like an actual uncommon, because it's really powerful in the deck that it works in, and in every other deck that it doesn't work in, it's just a Hurling Minotaur.
Yeah, which is like, okay.
Yeah.
Abyss Hunted, that's kind of my thoughts on Oath of the Gatewatch. Like, the third pack seemed really weird. And, like, the only reason it worked for me was because I ended up getting literally 6 cards in a row that were, like, just directly for my deck. Like, I got a Devoid, both of the Devoid boosting creatures, like the only cards that care about colorless creatures in blue.
I think, like, unless you can do that, the only thing your pack 3 does is give you some varying qualities of removal. So we have a Shatter to first pick, yeah. But there's also a Bone Splitter.
The Bone Splitter's the other card I'm looking at here. Tangle Root is not a card that you play. Mm-hmm. This is a combo card for silly combos involving a Cloudstone Curio. That's what this card's for.
Cloudstone Curio. Or you could. The first thing, I don't know if it works, but the first thing I thought of was Kobolds. Ways to bounce your Kobolds for free.
Cloudstone. No, that's what I mean. Cloudstone Courier is the way to do that.
Yeah.
Cloudstone Courier is whenever a card comes into play, bounce a card of the same type. I realize that's not the actual text, but it's close enough. Mm-hmm. So, Shatter versus Bone Splitter, huh?
Yeah, Shatter is like the more impactful power card in terms of what it does, its removal. Bone Splitter is more important for certain decks to work in terms of equipment.
And also will probably function in every deck?
Yeah, Bone Splitter will work in every deck. I guess so will Shatter if you're playing red.
Yeah.
Let's go with the Axe.
I'm going to go with the Axe because I went with Shatter last time.
Yeah. Luminous. Oh, there are tons of first pickable commons in this format.
Yeah.
Oh, Luminous Angel, is that a 7-drop what you want? Probably not.
It ain't bad. It's just that it's slow.
Mm. There's the obvious card that is Raise the Alarm.
Yeah.
And then, like, a Skyhunter Cub?
Also could be, like, this guy's okay. Wishes
yeah, Nurek Familiar and Anel are both also fine cards.
Yeah.
Looming Grid Sentinel is almost a really good card.
I guess the question is, if I wanted to be in white, would I pick Luminous Angel or Raise the Alarm?
Oh, triple white, but is a 7-drop. Other thing is also a 7-drop.
There's also Aether Spellbomb, too, but that's not... I don't feel too...
On your unsummon?
Yeah, I don't want to pick 2 by unsummon.
Raise the Alarm is the more playable card. Luminous Angel is like a bomb if you can actually cast it. Well, a slow
bomb. I'm going to go with the Angel.
Yeah.
Again, something different. Terror. Yeah. Or Gold Myrrh.
Gold Myrrh. There's a Frogmite here. Yeah. There's Disarm. Yeah,
Disarm.
There's also Leon and Blade Trap as a super trick.
It's expensive, but
it's a super trick. Yeah.
I always thought this art kind of ruled because I couldn't tell if the goblin fell into the trap or the goblin was summoning it and being really hardcore about it. I know that the goblin fell in here, like you can see.
I
want to believe it's just this is like a super metal goblin in the metal sense of the word.
Now, what I believe is that the answer to both questions is yes.
Yeah.
The goblin summoned the trap by being there, and then he got owned by it.
I guess I could also pick Viridian Joiner.
Viridian, yeah, to go with our Bone Splitter. Yeah. Slith Predator is like a not really cool guy.
It's okay. Terror is worse than it usually is. Hey, Bottleman.
Yeah, Terror is like pretty good most of the time, but pretty junk here.
Skyhunter.
Razor Barrier and Skyhunter Patrol,
Also, the gnomes.
I do enjoy Bottle Gnome. I don't like this art as much, but it's fine art. Yeah. Thought Prison.
Thought Prison is such a weird card, like in the sense that it's a 5-mana coercion that also can do damage.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Terror isn't, like, bad, it's just a lot worse. It's just, like, you know.
And Pacifism is sometimes rather bad in formats, like it wasn't so with Wizard Replica.
So I like how this is rolling right now, just because we've got, like, you know, this curve looks good.
Yeah, we need a 3, a 5, a 6.
Well, we don't need a 3, Goldmere.
No, Goldmere is a 2.
No.
We need to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
No, we don't need a 3 because we have.
Oh, we just skip right to 4. Dragon Blood, Lolean Scimitar. I was reading from left to right. Yeah. I was going to mention Zodcast, but I think Scimitar is an easy pick here.
Also, this is one of the better, like, Drudge skeleton type.
Yeah, he's also, I think, in Limited, one of the better Sliths.
Yeah.
Like, if you can sneak in the red Slith once, he's really strong. This guy could just sort of force through. Yeah. Also, he's a Drudge skeleton.
Also, Thoughtcast, I'd probably like if Wield or something like that. There's a, my deck feels like it's going to have a pretty hefty artifact count.
Yeah, we have 3 right now. We're going to get more. We're going to be able to pick up, like, some lands.
So expensive.
Yeah, a Goblin Replica. He's expensive, but...
still good.
You get a Grey Ogre out of your expensive Shatter. Like, he's a fine card.
Oh, yes, give me it again, but this time with more power.
Yeah, lean in Blade Warden. That guy is rather good. Yeah. Much better than Lean in Elder.
Lean in Elder wishes it was anywhere near... I think the red Slith is the best Slith pretty demonstrably, but the black Slith is better in Limited. And those are, like, those are different worlds.
Yeah, those are different worlds. Like, Stromkirk Noble is not so good in Limited much of the time, because you're probably not going to draw him on turn one, because you're playing Limited, so you probably aren't playing infinite one drops. Mm-hmm.
So we saw what the Blade Warden could do last time around, where the Blade Warden, like, you can equip all the equipment to the Blade Warden, tap it, then move all the equipment onto the creature that you pumped, I don't know, like, Skyhunter Patrol, and just crush in for, like, 9?
Also, we already have as many weapons as we did before. Tower of Champions, is that an 8 mana thing you're willing to pay for?
1 pack of Cloud Post, eh?
Cloud Post. Dead Iron Sledge would be better if we did have all those Raise the Alarms, but we don't.
It's like, see, none of the colored cards stand out to me. Dream's Grip just isn't good.
This is a format where you could probably get away playing Goblin Piker.
Is Rust Elemental? If you can't get this, is really.
If you're willing to give up the Piker pick, you can try Rust Elemental, but I don't think he'll work.
Yeah. So here's a card I always laughed at in Constructed. It's the laugh at target player who's trying to play 4 ofs. If they're like playing a control deck, it doesn't. If they're playing an aggro deck, they just don't care.
Yeah, they don't care.
So Stalking Stones is a reprint. And it was also a very important Constructed card because it allowed Mono Blue Control to exist in conjunction with Vedelkin Shackles.
Ah, it also allowed, like, Control to exist the first time it was printed.
Yeah, that was their win con.
Yeah. It was, like, one of the original man lands. So our guy didn't come back, but we have some Murs we can try to pick up. Or, like, a Blink Mothwell.
Blink Mothwell. Mur Adapter doesn't seem that good. This also doesn't seem that good.
Regress is not as good in this format as it was in...
It is okay. I could pick it bad. And maybe that... Maybe... I don't think Blink Mothwell does anything, because it's non-creature artifact.
Yeah, a lot of... I guess there are continuous artifacts in this set. What's the continuous artifact clause? But yeah, we'll look at blue.
Hey, all right. Ooh, wait, a null.
Yeah, null or Nurok Familiar.
Nurok Familiar would hit pretty nice because of like at least at this point it's a little under 50-50. But as far as cards, the problem is it's like we only have 1 pack of the lands, so we're not going to be able to get, like, 5 artifact lands, so the Nurok Familiar is going to have a really low hit chance.
Whereas an old here is just, like, a single mana counter spell for a lot of the really good spells in this format.
This card was a lot better when it had
damage on the stack. Okay, so now I don't think we're picking Disarm.
No, I'm grabbing Viridian Joiner because we technically have some cards that would work with it and, like, a reason to ramp.
Yeah, so we have a 7 drop, and it'd be like either that or what, Volshock Berserker?
Yeah, Volshock Berserker's alright, but I want to believe in, like, Joiner a little more. Razor Barrier coming back around, which is nice. I'll take that card.
That's fine.
So one problem we're going to have, and this is something that's pretty consistent in this format, creatures freaking suck.
Welcome to old Magic. Creatures are pretty bad. Like, that Griffin we have is one of the better creatures you could hope for.
Yeah, this set does have swords.
Steal the Slith, or we've already picked our Goblin Piker. We might not want to pick our 1/3.
I'll pick the Creeps.
Slith is Leadfoot or the Tangle Bloom.
I just want to point out this card's existence. And Dream's Grip. So we have a couple like Viridian Joiners on the sideboard, but it's actually quite fine. Why is it colored? That's weird. So we have a couple options for color. Steel Shaper Apprentice. So this card is like a tutor for.
He tutors for a one drop. Yeah, that's not awful though. There's Barbed Lightning.
Barbed Lightning is hella real.
What else is in here? Arcbound Fiend is a 6-mana 3/3.
Yeah. I like Chittering Rats a lot.
Chittering Rats is rather strong.
Check out the worst hill giant. This is pretty telling.
This is pretty telling of Pataron Ghost is bad. Murdered Land Shaper is bad. The Bolas is okay.
I think I can safely pass the rare and almost expect it to come back around. Mm-hmm. I'm almost wondering if I want to take that Barbed Lightning just because Barbed Lightning is hella real.
That would be a card you'd be okay splashing.
Yeah, there's also
a Bola. The Bola is like an okay tap thing.
Spider wishes it wasn't 6-mana.
Mm-hmm. Actually, he could sort of pull the Nefalia Seakai trick, but
I'm actually gonna pick the Bola. I've got a plan. I've got a different plan here. Ooh, Arcbound Reclaimer, huh?
Also, another Barbed Lightning.
Yeah, if I would have picked that first Barbed Lightning, I would have felt like a champion, but I didn't because I changed my mind at the last second. I don't think I've made a mistake. I don't think Reclaimer is worth it. And honestly, I think Barbed Lightning is still worth picking here.
Yeah. Also, show everybody Spin Crusher.
Here comes.
I love this card.
Here is the Doom Crusher.
Look at him. Look at this guy. I love this guy.
I love the Doom Crusher.
He's like zoo. What else is in here? Quicksilver Behemoth is like a funny guy. Tangle Golem was like my favorite common of the set back in the day. You cast that guy for cheaps. He doesn't look for a 7-drop. He is very cheap.
Yep.
Yeah, Ur-Golem's Eye. When Soul Ring and Worn Power, and we're Soul Ring and Thran Dynamo go to die.
Two. I'm not gonna pick Ingot to splash when the best card to splash is literally in the pack.
That's Mrs. Mask. Arcbound Hybrid is okay. Razor Golem.
Razor Golem.
He's a playable big guy.
We're in mainly white.
Mm-hmm. There's also a Chittering Rats. If we were the 4X Raise the Alarm deck again, the Nemesis Mask would be super great.
Yeah.
What the hell does Machinate do? Look at the top X's number of artifacts. One, do your hand in the right. Oh, so it's like a 3-mana Impulse for X. That's okay.
The cards I'm looking at here are Echoing Truth, Razor Golem.
Oh, I didn't even realize there was an Echoing Truth in here. Yeah, that card would also highly ruin the 4X Raise the Alarm deck.
Yeah. Yeah, the Razor Golem is nice because it can come down. I'm treating it as a 4-mana 3/4 Vigilance.
4-mana, sometimes even 3-mana.
It could be 3 if we're... Because white is our main color at the moment. Oh my god. Also, Barbed Lightning, the third. I guess I made a mistake not picking that first one because nobody's in red. So here's a cool card I'd like to show off.
Here's a EDH Darling.
Mm-hmm. Also, a card I always loved a lot.
Thunderstaff. Oh, the Thunderstaff. Yeah.
I always had, this was one of the, so Mirrodin was like in standard when I started playing Magic for like legitimately. And Thunderstaff was one of the cards I thought was just cool, you know? It's like, yeah, you take less damage and deal more damage, and you get to choose. You know, it's it, you know, it's a card that gives you choices, which makes you feel smart for choosing correctly.
Show everyone Vex.
Vex. So Vex comes from a time, which is still now, where they basically won't print counter-target spell on a card that isn't double blue without some drawback.
Mm-hmm. The only vexing thing about this card is why anyone would play it. Arcane Spyglass is also a strange card, but...
Hey, Mirrodin's Core. Oh, boy.
Wow, our 5-mana 3/3 tapper. That's like a modern card.
Yeah, I know. So here's the thing about... there's a cycle we've been seeing parts of. Echoing Truth. Echoing Such. I want you to check out Echoing Calm. A.K.A. the worst goddamn card.
Mm-hmm. There's also Darksteel Citadel in here if you just want to up your artifact count.
Sadly, I think with Raging Golem, I'm not really that huge on it.
There's also a Crystal Ball. In the form of Darksteel Pendant. Which is indestructible for some reason.
Well, they had the word Darksteel in it, and indestructible was created within this set, so...
It was a new keyword, and they wanted to...
How do you like 1-mana 1/1s with drawbacks?
I love them.
Okay, cool. How do you like... Well, what do you do? Right, the Artificer.
Mm-hmm. He really wishes he were like, what is that guy... The green magus of the guy who makes the...
Yeah.
I don't know.
So here's a card that actually was pretty nifty in worlds where you weren't, like, playing against super artifacts.
Yeah, 4-mana 5/5s didn't used to be a thing commonly. Yeah, the cloak.
It's either the cloak or the trident, and I think they do the same thing.
Yeah, because the trident just lets you throw the... Trident. It also has first strike. It's like an okay thing.
I could pick up like Unforge or whatever too. Like, admit that maybe I'm playing red too, but you know, check out these, like, so this is kind of the Darksteel pack, I suppose. Not a ton I really care about here. So Hollow is like Awestrike except for awful. Because
yeah, counter target burn spell.
That's all it does. It's this looks like Metroid Prime 2 something here.
I guess it would like counter a Sorin's Thunger. Yeah, Sorin's Thunger. There's a sorcery speed one of those kicking around somewhere.
Sorin's Thunger. I'm gonna pick
Sorin's Thunger. The playable card? Yeah.
Maybe. The Tangle Golem's also pretty cool, but I'm not gonna be green.
We're never getting green enough for Tangle Golem. Not even with Viridian Joiner. Sorin's Thunger. Ah! A 10-mana Muchwrath. I think that's probably pickable over like Inflame and Dross Golem and Arcbound Hybrid.
And Tears of Rage.
Yeah, Tears of Rage. That card isn't super terrible, but if you don't win the game when you cast it, you lose the game.
Yep. I'm going to pick the Bad Wrath that I'm probably not playing.
Hey. Again, an EDH darling. Oh, that guy's okay. He's like a welding jar on a guy.
I'll accept it. Mostly because, like, Shitty Flyer is slightly better here because of...
Yeah, we can suit up. We can make him unblockable.
Let me tell you a secret about Soulscour. Likely not making the deck.
Yeah. Like, also, it's really cool if we have, like, Razor Golem in the... Yeah, let's just admit that. Blue could become real if we see a reason to, but probably not.
The thing is, Barbed Lightning is better than every other reason we've seen so far.
Yep. Also, Barbed Lightning is highly splashable. Do you finally want to pick up, like, a... Well, it's either, like, Ritual of Restoration or Golem's Eye.
God, these all suck.
We do have a 7-drop in our deck, but that's like a regrowth. We have enough artifact creatures that one of them will die.
I'm going to grab the ritual and not like it and then see another ritual. Right? Yeah, there it is.
The Stoker. He's a Grey Ogre.
Sure.
We have a 7-drop in our deck.
Check out this card.
Yeah, Drooling Ogre. I like this guy's art a lot. Because look at him. He wants that anvil so much.
I know. Also, check out this 3-mana 1/1.
That's what fixing looks like these days.
Except for that doesn't fix. It makes target land an artifact.
Yeah, that's what I mean. That's what fixing looks like nowadays.
Yeah, I don't care.
And flame never works. Neither does hollow. Nobody wants hollows.
Okay, so we need creatures in here. We need about...
Five?
I'd say five. Five-ish. To feel good. Oh, wait, hollow, get out of here. Don't even try to...
Don't hide, hollow. Pray you never go hollow.
Pray I never go hollow. So check out our rare. It's a sweet card called Reversal of Fortune.
That is a pretty sweet card.
This card is horrible in about six different ways. Starting and ending with the art, really.
What? You don't like integrated metal bikinis? I don't know what's wrong with you. What do we actually have in here? We have Heliophile.
Oh, I found it.
Oh, there we go.
I found it below the cut. What happened?
Below the cut, yeah.
So it's either this or Skyhunter Prowler.
Yeah, Skyhunter Prowler is a cool guy, although it's a 3-mana 1/3. Sparring Collar is not the Skull Gear. We would be playing the Skull. What is that card even called? The one that actually gets played? Black, equipped to target creature you control.
Yeah, Cranial Plating.
+1/+. Cranial Plating. We would play Cranial Plating.
There's also, I would play it. Trinket Mage in a heartbeat because of our really good 1-mana things. So I'm not really super red, but this is like the best pinger in the damn world. So I'm going to admit that red is color number 2 pretty heavily now.
Oh, yeah.
Also, Joiner Adept. So in here, we're going to see some pretty interesting cards of Sunburst variety. We have these things here.
If Kavanaugh were here, he would be very, very heavily pushing for Skyreach Manta.
There's no way we could even support, like...
I know. There is the Trinket Mage if you want him.
Like, how in the fuck would I ever make more than 2 colors of mana?
I don't know. There's a Night's Whisper, the same argument. I'm going to start looking...
I'm looking at the blue, like, I don't know. Maybe, like, Trinket Mage is cool and would be worthwhile. I just don't know how I'm...
You can pick Mer Servitor and try to get as many Mer Servitors as possible.
Oh, boy. I don't know how I'd be able to support blue is the problem.
Man, look how bad that Onulet is.
It's really bad.
And it's not even Mega Onulet. The thing was like a dog's. Yeah, Suntouch Mer is a gray ogre.
I'm gonna go with looter. I'm not blue at all, but I'm gonna go with looter. Also, there's more looting, which is a lot better looking than against Rain of Rust.
And Armed Response. Actually, there's Wayfarer's Bauble.
No. No way. At least not right now. I'm just gonna support 3 color with a double red card. It's fine. Kavanaugh, I don't know if you've seen our deck, but it's actually impossible for that to be a 5-mana 5/5 flyer.
Yeah, it's probably going to be a 5-mana 1/1 flyer.
It could be a 3/3 flyer at best. I guess if I end up in 3 colors like this, I do want the sun-touched mirror, which would be fine.
And we do want the baubles as well, but we'll find them later.
Fixing's fake. You don't need it. You just draw your colors on time anyway.
Man, imagine Wayfarer's Bauble in standard, where 3-mana Rampant Growth is what you get anyways in green. Feedback Bolt is target player. I've stopped reading it.
I know, target player.
Heliophile again. Devouring Shadows.
Yeah, Devouring Shadow.
That's a good vendetta. It's actually a bad vendetta, but it's still a vendetta.
It's a vendetta. It targets black creatures, which is why it's double black.
Stand Firm is like an okay trick as far as bad tricks go. Yeah. Ferropede has cool art.
So one thing about Stand Firm and all the other Scry cards in this set... like lose hope over there, which is the same dude, like
same card, but kind of, same dude in a situation.
The scry is always two in this set. Every single scry card is scry two.
And so if you think of a card that's good at scry two, it's probably from here.
Mm.
Like Magma Jet.
How many times can I pick Thought Courier?
I don't know. Actually, we should pick Grinding Station.
I saw the Grinding Station and thought about it.
If there were Blasting Station, we would pick it.
Right, but this is the Mill Station, like.
Yeah.
So the stations, there's four of them. If you get all four, you basically have an infinite combo going on. Do I want more Thought Courier, or do I want Sun-Touched Myrrh?
If we're in two colors, the Myrrh's a Gray Ogre. If we're three, it's a Trained Armadon. Whereas we have two Thought Couriers already.
Yeah, but, like, the more Thought Couriers I have, the more looting I get to do.
You can loot away a Thought Courier to draw anything.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, the problem with Grinding Station is we have a semi-okay way of untapping it.
I think this is going to be the Loxodon Anchorite. Or the Opaline Bracers.
Opaline Bracers... So, Myrrh Quadrupod, who also has art I like.
Sadly, again, damage on the stack absolutely took this one out. Mm-hmm. Like, it's costed as though it works as a 4-4, and it absolutely doesn't.
Yeah. What else is there? Blind Creepers.
Blind Creepers is a silly card.
Lunar Avenger.
Check out this 6-mana spell.
Yeah, this is what they made Affinity to be, and somehow failed.
There's another Grinding Station.
There is yet another Grinding Station. Also a Pentad Prism.
Oh boy.
Yeah.
Is that the sort of fixing I'm gonna need?
I don't know. it's like, do we pick the Pentad Prism or do we just try out Grinding Station?
How many artifacts do I have? If I pick Grinding Station, maybe I can get all those servitors back, and then I win.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 artifacts in the deck.
I'm gonna pick the stupid card, that's fine. Fixing, it needs more fixing.
Well, it takes your two colors and fixes your third.
Mm-hmm. Ah, Spark Elemental.
That's the kind of red we're getting, right? Like, it's like... Our choices are Battered Golem, Disrupting Aura, Conjurer's Bauble, Spark Elemental, and Horned Helm. We could have a worse Lean and Scimitar.
Spark Elemental is a very well, it's a known card from this set because it's a kind of nifty.
It's a lightning, kind of lightning bolt type card.
Yeah.
You want to play Reversal of Fortune?
Not really.
And then
I want to play Razorgrass Screen. Oh boy. Spark Elemental is real.
Spark Elemental is real. Razorgrass Screen is probably going to trade with something for until like turn 5.
Sounds awful.
It's either that or Stand Firm.
I'm in.
Sounds awful. I'm in. That's what I like to hear.
Here's an EDH card.
Mm-hmm. I like how all the writs in this set have, like, the same art, only slightly different.
So you got bad news. If the deck is just now starting to worry you, I've been worried for about a pack and a half now.
Kinda the same.
White basically, like, stopped showing up.
I mean, Abjurist Chant. Okay, so we're playing 3-color with no fixing.
That's fine.
Yeah, all of our color requirements are pretty light, except for Volshock Sorcerer.
Yeah.
I have good news, though. We have 20 creatures.
There are a lot of bad ones.
I'm going to say most of them are. Like, let's,
I'd say there's, like, 6 good ones, because Volshock Sorcerer exists. Thought Courier is Merfolk Looter, so I'll call that a good creature.
That's a good creature, too. Oh, so Immediate Cuts, Sparring Collar.
Yeah.
Anodense Lurker.
X2. Razorgrass Screen, Stand Firm, probably second Razorgrass Screen.
We're at 26, we need 3 more cuts.
Yeah, the Razorgrass are pretty... I feel pretty confident that I can get out of here, too. I'm not going to grind anybody to dust here.
Okay, we're down to 16 creatures. What are our non-creatures? We have Razor Barrier as a super trick. Regress as, like, a regress.
I wish my blue was slightly better.
Yeah. If we cut blue, we have to add in some bad creatures.
Yeah, I know.
But Trinket Mage and Thought Courier and Annul are all pretty grand. When is Battered Golem still in here? Can we go down to 15 creatures? Are you okay with that?
I don't think this card is bad. I think it's not... I don't think it's good. I just don't think it's bad.
Yeah, we'll probably be able to untap him. Arcbound Hybrid's, like, okay. It's not great, but... 4-mana 2-2 is... Well, you're not cracking Stalking Stones unless you have 6 mana anyways. So, 2 cuts. I think Regress is one of them.
I'm thinking. There's a lot of going through my head here, trying to figure out if I can cut a color. I don't want to cut red, because red is actually way too good. All 3 of its cards are quite good. Mm-hmm.
If you cut...
Buddy, the hybrid's pretty freaking bad. Like, there's only 3 or 4 artifact creatures in the deck. Yeah, that's the whole point. Like, there are only 5. Sorry, 5. Like, the only creature it's any good to mod on is to the Razor Golem. Anyway, it's probably an easy cut. I'm just sitting. Like, the problem is I don't want to cut it yet because it won't. Like, I need to. Like, if I do this, if I cut like this, then I have. Honestly, I might cut Stalking Stones just because of the 3 colors going on.
That's fair. He's just a 3/3 at the end of the day.
Yeah. Mostly because 3 colors of the colorless land sounds like a good way to have that in every opening hand.
That sounds like a... how you say... Battle for Zendikar draft.
Kind of wish I had something I could... I don't really care for Whisper Silk Cloak in this deck because there's very little it's any good on.
Put a bad creature in over it then. Like, Anodette Lurker or...
I guess I can do some dumb shenanigans with Auroch Blade Warden and then moving the Whisper Silk Cloak on and then...
Whisper Silk Cloak is also like a clock sort of thing. What are like the least worst creatures we could put in over one of our worst or piece of equipment? 5-mana 3/3 gains us some life. Razorgrass Screen. It's Arcbound Hybrid.
We're talking 5-mana 3/3 and 4-mana 2/2, both of which have almost very negligible abilities.
It could also be Regress.
Maybe that's more. A trick. I don't know. Like, it might just steal a game, too, so maybe it's not worth, like...
If it ends up being brick in our hand, we can bring out something. Yeah, Ogre Leadfoot is, like, a playable 5-mana 3/3, funnily enough, but he's on one of our splash colors. I don't like bringing him in. Although, really, we're kind of not... It says they're splash colors, but they're not super flat splash colors.
Right.
Like, we're fine though. We have tappers. Like, we have Mystic, and more realistically, the Lean and Bola. Well, I like playing the best pinger in the world.
I don't disagree about the Volshock Sorcerer. Double red is really freaking harsh. I don't like my other options, though.
It would be like regress over it. Or any bad creature.
Screw it. I'm just going to accept that my mana freaking blows. This is a really, like... This deck is three color and not good for it. Something like 755 is awful, but
I think that'll get us there. Our only heavy white cost is at 7. Yeah. I like this. I like where we're going.
I don't at all. I think this deck loses pretty quickly. I'm trying to
see. I do too, but I'm trying to have. I'm trying to be positive.
You know what? Well, thank you. Thank you.
You gotta believe, man. Gotta believe.
All right. I'll believe.
Hope can't die.
I'll have all three colors in my hand, and like a Mantis Rider will just appear in my hand on turn three.
We'll play Trained Armadon, and nobody can compete with that. And we're going to make it unblockable.
Is this what you wanted, Kavanaugh?
This is definitely what Kavanaugh wanted.
Was this your dream? let's go lose some games of Magic and then go cube.
Yeah! Hell is real! And I live there! Actually, I don't. And I won't either.
You're leaving hell.
No, I'll be moving several hours away from it, I think. Kavanaugh, shut it up.
I'm sure you rolled the D20 to pick each card in the pack. Nah, that's not
what
true.
What sort of happened? We went into white, and yes. White was pretty good to us pack one. Pack two was Darksteel.
Yeah, pack two was good up until like the back half of it. Pack three
kind of fell apart. Like, we didn't get anything out of pack three. I think one thing that happened is we saw those barbed lightnings going around, and that signaled to someone so that the open signal we could have picked up got snapped up pretty quick. Although I say that we got past three of them in a row, but.
People telling me I love people telling me cards in my main deck are really bad when they don't realize that. Yeah, I know. Like,
yeah, we realize this. Dragon Ball Z. Anyway, but the real thing is, maybe we've engaged Chaos Draft mode.
You see, you think that happens, but that actually happens maybe like 1% of all drafts you even think it does. Like,
I know. I've seen it happen once.
Okay.
And therefore, I apply it to every time. And if it ever happens, it's... You know how called shots work.
I'm aware. I'm just calling you out on it.
How does this hand look? Deep. It's got bar... It's got...
I see a 3 and a 4 play.
Yeah.
But yeah. The deck I have, I'm not entirely, like, the happiest with. Just based on... the three color thing going on. Also, all you haters on Volshock Sorcerer.
Yeah, if we get a Plains, we could just, like, if we draw Plains next turn, we could just not play Mountain and play our Razor Golem down. He's already a pretty good hill giant.
The Dead Iron Sledge.
Interesting.
It was a top deck from our opponent. Hey, a 2.
That lets us not play Mountain yet.
Yep, so the trick here is that, yes, I could draw Volshock Sorcerer and not be able to play it on turn 3, but there's a 5 in 31 chance that I draw the Plains rather than the Volshock, which means...
Which is a 1-1.
Yeah. Yeah, okay, that's a 2-2.
What the hell does that even do? Can't be blocked.
It gives your team unblockable if you have an artifact land on the other side.
It gives them artifact land walking. Okay.
Yeah, that's the idea. Anyway, so, go elf from here.
Do we hold up the lightning, or do we just get Whisperwind Cloak down?
I'm getting this down. I'm very happy about our really, really terrible creatures. Go Piker.
What does that guy do again? Prevents
the next 2 damage. Our opponent's 3 colors, too.
Ah.
Yeah, prevents the next 2 damage that would be dealt to something.
Ah, I know why you picked that card, then. Also, he's a 4-mana 2/3, which used to be vanilla. Strictly worse bear? I think that's AI's just a Grey Ogre.
I think we call
it. Or is this just... We have a Piker?
I think that's called Piker.
Oh, alright, Goblin Piker. Yeah.
So, the real question is, what the hell's there for?
The aggressive choice is Razor Golem, which is also a kind of defensive choice. Except if he puts the Dead Iron Sledge on anything, we're not blocking.
Yeah, but then I just, put the Whisper Seal Cloak down and it's fine. Holy hell, Second Sight. So, this card doesn't do anything. It's index plus look at mine in index.
Yeah, we're going to,
I accept.
Little does he know, if he makes us draw a lot of planes, we're okay with that. Although he might know our terrible secret that we're 3-color now.
He might. I'm really happy about this. Yeah, I don't think his 4 could have been better. Cloud Manta was the only 4 he could have played that I would have said, yeah, that was better. That's it.
Yeah, Cloud Manta.
Is it Cloud Manta? Cloud Golem. Whatever the 4-mana affinity for islands creature whose name I can't recall.
Yeah, the one that gets played in Pauper.
It's a 6-mana. 6-mana affinity for islands, 2/4 flyer. I don't remember the name.
It's an Azure Drake much of the time, but sometimes it's cheap. Yeah, because it was blue.
Well, it was a defensive creature that could get played out of that deck.
Yeah.
It's basically the blue version of this card. So.
Yeah.
I would have called that a good play.
Not Cobalt Goat. That was the one with the blue activation from Mirrodin. These guys were from Darksteel, I think.
Yeah. Anyway, let's see what we get. Not that that really does much, but...
Nah, it lets us hold up 1 red, if we want to.
Yep. Yeah, I don't think that changes anything.
Yeah, I think we just play down the Golem and then attack. This will probably prompt our opponents to equip the sledge and attack, or maybe hold back with the sledge.
Well, I mean,
although we have the cloak in play.
We have the cloak in play.
That's probably just going to be what happens for the next few turns, is the Golem attacks.
So here's the cool thing about this index. Our opponent's going to draw good cards here.
What does that do?
Discard 2 artifacts, untap this permanent. And once we untap it, we're good.
Okay. I guess he controlled our draws. So I guess we aren't drawing any artifacts for a while.
Or maybe we are. Who knows? I mean, Trinket Mage would give us an artifact.
Yeah, Trinket Mage would. It would give us...
It would give us an artifact I'd likely just want to play, but...
Yeah, like the Scimitar or something.
Yeah.
Bone Splitter Armor. Ah, all in.
There's more planes. So I'm going to play the planes and... So, yeah, the thing is here, my opponent is going to be drawing good cards, like I just said, and then they're going to taper off, because that's how indexing works. And then the other way indexing works is that our opponent is going to... We are going to draw bad cards, followed by good cards.
Followed by... Or, hopefully, that's the official plan.
Yeah.
Hear it.
Or yeah! Draw bad cards no matter what happens. Equip.
At what point do we just barbed lightning his dude and his face?
With our opponents either on 3 life or goes to equip a Nurox health suit, I suppose.
Ah. We can't play that and the mirror, so it's either play the mirror or...
Do I care about the mirror, or do I just want to equip Whisper Seal Cloak?
On the mirror?
No. He indexed both players. He entwined the card.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, I can't... I know that he has double blue up. I'm not gonna fall for that trap. I just don't know if I care if a 2-2 has stealth. Or Shroud.
Shroud, yeah. We probably don't care. The question is, do we care to suit up ourselves? If he trades with Alphamur, that's fine.
Maybe just attack, play Goldmer? I don't know if I even want
to... Yeah, we may not want to... Let's just... Yeah, our plan. Yeah, our Goldmer might be our way to untap our Golem.
That's more what I was thinking.
Ah.
I'm just going to attack, and then... I'm not going to play this mirror because it's better off as a card to untap with Psychic Overload. And also, this lets me have Barbed Lightning in response if my opponent plays a more relevant threat and does not leave up.
Well, if we were, I was in the scenario I was talking about, we attack with both guys.
Yeah.
Which is what happened.
Right, because I have no reason really to. I don't want to hold this back to stop his guy from attacking because, like, every attack I hit is another turn off this clock.
Yeah. Double blue pants is let down.
Nope. Heliophile. So, this can sack to deal 3 damage. Which I can prevent 2 of.
Unless he... Yeah, he can't do it right now either. Okay. Interesting!
So this was the 4th card, right?
Perhaps.
Yeah, this is the 4th card.
Do I just windmill slam that, or...?
Do I wait 1 turn on the Trinket Mage?
To see if you get just draw the artifact or not.
Well, here's the thing: he indexed. The card on top of my deck is the 5th card.
Yeah.
Shuffling may be a mistake. So I'm just going to attack with Elfamir.
We do play the land though. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It was. Yeah. Elfamir attacks. We hold up things.
Yep. So this is a trick against Heliophile. File.
I don't know. I don't think you. That's a fake word, so just pronounce it however you like.
Oh, Heliophile sounds right. I want to see what the card I draw is. Also, I don't feel under pressure at this point.
Yeah, the only real threat our opponent has shown has been Gray Ogre.
Yeah.
And they're playing Steel Wall and Urgolem's Eye. The other cards have been pretty... And
I was actually going to say, Dead Iron Sledge on Steel Wall is at least something.
Yeah, Dead Iron Sledge in general is like a acceptable card.
Alright, but... so here's the 5th card. Island. Alright. I've been gotten good. Let's go ahead and grab a... So here's the thing. I actually can't unequip this Whisper Silk Cloak.
Yeah.
Because that would be a really good way to lose.
He would heliophile our guy?
Yes.
Question is, do we just get, like, the bolas and start tapping down his wall and attacking the next turn? Or do we just get Bone Splitter and attack in for four.
I can't attack in for four.
Shroud, yes.
Yeah. Again,
question remains. Or do we want to get something to pitch to untap our guy?
The moment I unequip that Whisper Silk Cloak, my creature is dead. I'm not going to do that.
Yeah, we can't do that. I think the Repster didn't realize it was Shroud. Like,
yeah,
I forgot
yeah,
it was Shroud.
Yeah, I know. Shroud is not hexproof. I can only prevent two, though. Oh, I can...
Yeah.
I can equip the Bone Splitter on this, but, like, I can't attack with this.
Not through Dead Iron Sledge.
I'm going to grab Bone Splitter, I guess.
Like, they that are the Bola. The Bola blocks this guy. It taps this guy.
Actually, yeah, let's do it this way. So, here's the whole... Here's my new plan. Check this out.
Oh. Do we just abandon Alphamur? Who cares? It's Goblin Piker.
Yeah, I was gonna say, okay, yeah, you've got the line I'm thinking of. he's gonna sack it to target it, so then we have to tap it. So for the next damage, it would be dealt to target creature. So this is targeting, yep, so prevent it.
And then we put Bone Splinter on Alpha Bird attack.
No, we don't unequip.
Well, yeah, we don't unequip. Else we would have to do the whole thing again next turn.
However,
the Alpha Bird can still attack because how Dead Iron Sledge works.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this is game one, match one. You missed the draft. You missed the draft going pretty poorly. I guess he did trade up his steel wall.
For Alphamir.
When Kraken Hatchling and Goblin Piker meet.
Boy.
Death usually doesn't follow.
But sometimes but it does. So does our opponent actually have, like, things there? No, they're just gonna...
Okay.
Get rocking. They're following okay. suit. They're just gonna follow suit.
Do we attack with Trinket Mage?
We draw. Oh, okay, we draw counters. I was hoping we drew an artifact.
To untap your guy. Oh, let's attack.
Yep. Sure.
Gray Ogre, go.
Deploying
our Grey Ogre is better. Wow.
Deploying Grey Ogre.
Opponent is deploying their Grey Ogre.
Anyway, I guess this is what I get for bad mouthing Whisper Silk Cloak. It just shows up and.
Crush. It just crushes. Shows up and crushes on our 4 mana 2 3. Yay! Okay, so our opponent has one creature in their deck that can attack.
That's fine. I don't think. Before you ask about sideboarding, the answer is no, because there's no options over here.
Yeah, like, our options equates to.
Let's just rock.
Yeah. I think our two options are the Ogre, in case our opponent has really artifact creature heavy, and then Regress. Echoing.
Soul Scour in.
Yeah, Soul Scour with our Razor Golem in play to try to do that. But, yeah.
I mean, my deck's already, like, got a bunch of unplayable cards. I could add one more to the pile. That probably wouldn't be that.
Yeah, what's one going to change anything?
Wrath kills 50% of its creatures. It's true.
I think a little more than that, actually.
Steel Wall.
Oh, yeah. Well, I thought you meant our creatures, but yeah, it kills 50% of his creatures, too.
It kills 50% of creatures, okay?
It could be a 7 mana removal spell that destroys all our lands to kill a Grey Ogre.
So I'd like to introduce you to the mana cost on Soul Scour. It's actually white, 7.
Yeah, it costs 10. All right, I was mixing it up with Bad Wrath, which actually costs 6, but causes you to entwine to destroy.
Which is a good card, limited, because it's a Wrath.
Because it's a Wrath of God, but... Okay, it kills 49% of creatures. I'll accept that.
I see Lane and Scimitar and Arc Blade Warden.
Yeah, this seems fine. Also, we've got interaction.
Yeah.
Like, we can just go island, hold up a null. That might do something. Maybe our opponent is also on island. Or we could just get down the Scimitar.
I don't believe it.
Okay. Wow, we even have Alfheimer as a creature to attack with Arak Blade Warden's help. A mana dork.
That's a good
Our opponent apparently has some top end.
That's a good mana dork. Wow.
It is.
Right. Let's get the Blade Warden down. So
hopefully. Yeah. The battle of the two mono 1/1s with abilities. Well, me and Jinns have a nuanced way of working together.
That's true.
Which is I give bad advice and then he ignores it. Sometimes he doesn't and then he loses the game.
Sometimes I don't and I win the game.
Yeah.
So what's it gonna be, buddy?
What's
Trinket Mage got today?
What do you got? Aether, where's your Soul Ring?
Aether Spell Bomb or something? Yeah, Soul Ring. Where's your Skull Clamp?
Where's your clamp? Yeah, God.
Show me your goddamn Skull Clamp.
If it's actually clamp, we're ruined.
Great Furnace has entered the revealed card zone.
Yo!
Grind.
You just played Civic... Bah!
Uh-oh.
Our opponent just play Civic Wayfinder?
Yeah, Civic Wayfinder. It's good.
Bah! We need lands, by the way.
I would
we
take
kept
any
a two-lander. Called chats. You put the sword on the Blade Warden? You should sacrifice an artifact. Sacrifice your grinding station to mill two, please.
I'm actually gonna leave the blue up.
For a null.
Mm-hmm. Mostly because my opponent's on 6 mana.
Yeah. You could destroy your Great Furnace in response to this to untap your grind. Okay.
Okay.
If that's true, the Repster, our opponent is playing 3 color with a colorless land.
Yeah, agreed. Have you seen what we're doing?
We're just playing a bad deck, not necessarily a soup. We're playing a greedy deck out of necessity. That's a choice. Oh, he plays Pest Engine, we counter it. But he didn't. Anyways. Blocking 4/4 or attack for 4, which is more.
I'm just gonna hit for 2.
Oh no, the 2/2 is like it gives your creatures artifact land walk, only they didn't. They were as ambivalent about Landwalk back then as they are now.
So 5 cards in hand.
Okay, 4 cards in hand.
Yeah, they still got a lot of gas. I don't know. I'd like to draw a land. Battered Golem's real bad. What do you got here, bud? Oh, that's seven?
For an artifact spell.
For an artifact spell, you say. Seven mana, eh?
He is tapping his grinding sage.
Grinding the dust, you say.
Okay, he milled our seven drop and a,
and a,
and a burn spell.
What's your... I assume you've got... A 4-4 first striker.
Sure.
I'm good. Thanks.
Isn't that an invasion creature? Steelleaf Paladin?
Yeah, except for that was six.
True.
Anyway, I would like it if my opponent attacked. Okay, he did not. That's fine. Alright, so I'm going to play Razor Golem. Oh no! I've untapped his grinding stick.
Okay, so the mirror goes in. And we might pump because we have a 3-4 on the ground.
That's
the stop is a block anyways.
That's what I'm thinking. Yeah. I wanna get through for damage right now.
Yeah, Null's pretty good.
So
it's been pretty okay every time they've printed it.
Oh,
oh boy.
Oh shit. Yeah, all right.
That'll only be a 3-3 first strike, though, because he destroyed his great furnace.
No, that's not. That was just modular. It's not sunburst. It's just a 4-4.
Oh, it's just a 4-4 then.
Yeah, I'm just.
Well,
gonna,
that's a little problematic.
It's what the bola.
Let's tap it. Yeah, we've
that's
got
what
a bola.
The bolas are for. I just moved the bola somewhere else.
Unless he pulls like Whisperwind Cloak out of us. Or his the Nurok battle suit.
I want to play the gold mirror because I want something for this bola to be on that's better than because this doesn't function.
Yeah, it independent abilities.
Yep. I don't know how much E-Witness is worth on MTGO. Oh, nice.
Ah, super trick. That is a way to potentially kill his 4-4 first strike.
I'm going to move the bola and just attack with Razor Golem. Oh. So attack with Razor Golem.
See if he blocks.
Mm-hmm. He probably does, and he probably grinds.
Yep, that's fair. And we can force him to block, force him to grind.
Yeah. So here's the grind. Three lands, all right.
Not upset with that, especially since one of them was an island.
And then I'm going to just play Gold Mirror. Actually, no. He's going to play his guy. I can play Gold Mirror and move the bola.
Yeah, he's just going to play his guy down again.
I'm sitting here thinking, like, do I need to play around removal? But no, he's just going to play his big guy. Like,
yeah.
There's no... And we keep up a null as a...
Yeah, we keep up the trick we've already spent.
Yeah.
Okay, so our opponent...
So land, and then he's going to play his guy, which I'm just going to tap down.
Yeah, we'll just tap, like, immediately.
Yeah, so there's a 4-4.
Behold.
However, when he gets another artifact creature, that's going to become dangerous because he can modular.
Yeah.
What do I care to do right now?
Um, you can attack with the Razor Golem and then go from there.
You can attack with Razor Golem and Alpha Mirror? You could
also attack with Alpha Mirror. Alpha Mirror would probably trade with either of his guys, and we're probably okay with that.
Well, I mean, I can pump it.
Yeah.
All right, I've got a plan. So we're going to attack with both. I'm not going to do any pumping and moving because I'm going to need all my mana this turn, which is fine. So attack with both.
They got rid of all the Taco Bell emotes. They did. And they got rid of...
I'm
KZ
sorry.
Skull is also gone.
I'm sorry they got rid of TB Spicy Pokecaptain. It's
TB Spicy was one of my favorites.
Sure. Let's go ahead and get our kill then. Yep.
So we'll go up to a 4-3, and then he battle grits us, and we're fine.
Yeah, right. So the way I'm going to do this here is I'm going to play Battered Golem. Which is only getting one attack in. But that's good enough for me. Or maybe it's just going to be a defender. I don't know. And then we'll go ahead and equip on Razor Golem so that I have a tapper still. Because I want to leave Razor Barrier up in case of fire. Like, in case he plays that enchantment that would lock me down.
Well, the cigarette people pay more than Taco Bell does.
Tap target creature. So again, him playing an artifact creature is the biggest threat he could do, because that would allow him to move his modular counters around.
Yeah.
It wouldn't even be that bad, because I do have, like, Razor Barrier up my sleeve, but also I'd love it if he attacked. Tanglewalker. Alright, so...
Gray Ogre.
No text. End of land. Sweet. Alright, so we're...
Yeah, our opponent is empty-handed.
Oh boy! Bone splitter, you say.
You want to do some math?
You want to force a trump block?
I definitely want to force a trump block.
I could have done that post combat, but I want to do this pre because this is going to force a goddamn trump block pretty hard.
Yeah, and we lose what? A battered golem attack?
Yeah, so. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and pump the Alpha Mirror. Alpha Mirror pump. +4. And then we'll go ahead and move the equipment around. Oh, how do I want to move the equipment? Do I care? Do I want to just go on in with my creatures anyway and call it a day?
If you don't put the Lean and Scimitar on the Golem, he can one for one trade with it.
No, hold on. 4. He's one. I'm one short of lethal.
I think we force the chump then, because we can't really squeeze the lethal in next turn, can we?
Well, the lethal is literally just attacking Razor Barrier. Oh, I can't get by. I could. Yeah, I could tap the green creature and then Razor Barrier in for the last points for off of the green creature. So I'm just gonna leave this up. Yeah, okay. So here's my idea. I'm not tapping down a blocker. I don't have lethal. I'm close to lethal. I'm very close, but it's not actually lethal.
Yeah, I would trust him on that. I'm bad at shitty quick math, but he's good at it. I have to sit and think. He probably does too, but the difference is that I actually don't sit and think, but he does.
I'm just taking my damage.
I'll just hit you for 7 and trade off our bad creatures.
And then equip. We were close to lethal. Like, if I tap down a blocker, he still can block enough there. Actually, no, I guess if I do that tap, he blocks the Razor Golem and I'm one short. So... There's close to lethal there. I'm fine with that in all ways. Basically, mostly because I have freaking lethal next turn.
Yeah.
My opponent's at 2. I don't see this, like, all of a sudden turning around.
If you are going to, like, talk about what the correct play you saw was, you should perhaps say what it was. That's just, you need to equip Golem to the Golem, tap something, then play down Bone Splinter. It untaps the Golem. Right, we could...
I don't have the mana for Razor Barrier on that turn, then.
Yeah, we would be one mana down short, so we would... He would still have a blocker open.
I couldn't Razor Barrier past the blue creatures with this. Oh, that actually could probably still be lethal. Anyway, I don't care, either way. The game was clearly over regardless of whatever my opponent top decked.
Especially since our opponent is empty gripped and we could just force lethal damage by attacking with all creatures.
Yeah, I'm not even going to bother with tricks. There's no reason to. But yes, I believe you're correct in that if I do like the Leon and Bola handoff thing, which is a pretty cool play, I can tap down most of his blockers.
We didn't want to think about battered Golem too much, though.
No, I don't. I'm trying to think how much that actually gets through. And if I could cast Razor Barrier in the same turn, maybe. I don't know. It doesn't matter to me because I won the match.
Yeah, how much waiting do we have to do? I wonder is the
only
question.
One left.
Rom Amni and Morg for you.
I feel pretty decent about, like, battered Golem doing something. That was nifty.
Yeah, he was a warm body when we needed him to be.
Yeah. But no, the main reason I didn't care there is that with my opponent empty-handed, and I'm holding Razor Barrier, I can't see a card my opponent could top deck to get them out of the situation. And if I can't see a single card that my opponent could have top decked to get them out of the situation, I don't, it's fine.
Maybe they snuck an upheaval onto the draft.
Oh man, that would rule.
Yeah.
They go ahead and like slam down a Soul Scour and then it's just like, wait, we still have a bunch of creatures.
Yeah. No, they just cast upheaval with their mono. That's why they were playing all those mono rocks and mono dwarfs.
Right.
So it's because they have so they could upheaval.
Mm.
So they could cast the Ur-Golem Eye off the dork mana and immediately get two more mana back. Yeah.
I can't believe TB Spicy's dead.
I thought it would live forever. I love you, Taco Bell. Really, live moss, everybody. Buy a box of food at 2 a.m. and eat it.
But no, if I go back to... where am I going back to? I'll tab over to here. I'm not going to jump into a dual queue. That's not happening. But yeah, that deck sort of felt like the Chaos Draft was real, but our deck somehow came together. Here's the problem. The Chaos Draft is never real. You just play against the other player who basically had never played the format.
True, which is probably what we just happened there. If we were forcing mono color in cube, we would be forcing mono red because I've been trying to get us to do that forever. We always end up first picking upheaval or something, though. It just happens that way.
What was the one? What happened last time where it was like? Could
we
have
had
been...
I had that sweet Burrows deck that just lost to a Timely Wrath. I don't really know else what happened.
It was this one, right?
Yeah, that one. The Heartbeat of Spring. That was Storm. That was our Tendrils deck.
There was one. Which was the one that was like there was like a mono red deck that we could have forced and we didn't. I know it was one of these.
Oh yeah, there was. Storm. When we did Storm, I was keeping track of the mono red deck that
right.
I made. It would have been really sweet, and I would have lost to Show and Tell.
Oh, right. So, the one thing about tracking the draft like that, and I know I've mentioned it to you, but I like to mention it because it's a fact.
It actually doesn't work.
Right. The only cards that you can factually know in that manner are the first 8. That's
yeah,
it.
Yeah, because the rest of them become influenced by the other choices.
Right.
The mono red one I could sort of assume would happen, though, because almost all those cards ended up wheeling. Which was, like, we saw, like, late Lightning Bolt, and that was amazing.
That was pretty weird.
Like, that shouldn't happen. Splash for Lightning Bolt, kids. It'll treat you well.
You can kill the Storm player when they're sitting there trying to think about how to storm off.
Yeah, they necro down to 1, and then you're like, okay. I shoot you at your instep when you put the cards into your hand, and then nothing hit before the cards actually hit your hand. And then you just lose.
I don't know. If my phone could probably do Hearthstone. I keep... Man.
Mm. Yeah.
No, I was just thinking about Hearthstone, that's all.
I want to see cube support for Goryeo's Vengeance. I want to see Borborygmos Enraged, and Grissard is already there. I want to do that. Please let me do that. No, just do that in your Storm deck. Have that be a part of your Storm deck. Like, Storm deck plays Grizzlebrand anyways.
Do you remember that Storm player we played against that their plan was reanimate Grizzlebrand? I mean, that's a good freaking plan. Holy hell.
They were playing Storm and also Oath of Druids with like Elishnorn and Grizzlebrand and also Yawgmoth's Will. So they had like 3 different poisons to play Oath of Druids.
It was kind of nuts, to be entirely honest.
What happened to them? Like, they were... Was it the Pokeball? That wasn't the Brain Freeze deck, was it?
That was
it?
The Pokeball
because
player.
Because that guy was also playing Trinket Mage.
That was the Pokeball player. He was...
Yeah, that guy was insane.
Yeah, the because they had Storm combo, but the only card they had to combo off with was Brain Freeze.
Yeah. And they had to try to trip catch Kaz's Eldrazi in his hand, yeah, but it never happened.
They tried twice to catch it in the Pokeball. Yeah. See, here's the thing. I don't know when it's best to try to, like, so here's the thing about the Pokeball and catching it. You have to wait until Kaz's health is low enough to try to use the Pokeball. In that you want to trigger it the less cards that he had in his deck.
It reminded me
But every time you miss, your clock gets worse and worse. Like
it reminded me of I was there in spirit because I was in the zoo in Holleran, but it was you and Kaz doing Kamigawa.
You were literally all
every time you cast, you had Elder Pine of Jukai in play, and you were casting Glitter Fang repeatedly to try to find.
No, see,
Hidetsugu's second right.
My favorite thing about that is there's the turn before I draw Hidetsugu's second right, I pass on playing it. I could play the Glitter Fang just to look at the top 3 in cycle, but I pass knowingly.
Because at that point it's like, okay, it's been a long time since we've seen Hidetsugu's second right.
And that was the game. That was the die.
Well, the secret champion there was Emberfist Zubura.
Because it couldn't be stopped.
it couldn't fail. So, either alive or dead, that man did his job.
Mm-hmm. No matter what.
Kamigawa was going to be fun for like a bunch of reasons.
People talking about that Darksteel ingot that might have been good in our deck. I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, Darksteel ingot was like in the same pack as Barb Lightning. Like, we had a choice where we could have picked a Darksteel ingot or Barbed Lightning, and then a choice where we could have picked a Merfolk Looter or Wayfarer's Bauble. Then Ixabaron. That's not what our first Kamigawa plan is. Our first Kamigawa plan is, in fact,
Rat Tribal. Thoughts.
No. Rat Tribal is good, too. Because I like most of the rats in Kamigawa.
Yeah, Dampen Thought.
Dampen Thoughts.
I'd love to get... Oh, man, they went to Game 3.
We get to talk about Dampen Thoughts more. And about sure. Candles.
Well, the thing is that this round is over in at the longest 14 minutes, so...
Yeah.
Mighty Neutron, I looked, when I typed out that one and realized that I had put up 200, I was like, what the hell? Well, the thing is, Elder Pine to Jukai is in Saviors. And the next draft I'm going to do on the past drafts is Triple Champs. I think that's
Triple actually, Champions.
Where's the list for these? Where's the
Google MTGO Year of Modern Flashbacks.
Modern. All right, let's find this Year of Modern Flashbacks. So I just want to, because what's next week's, like, what's the okay, sorry. There's nothing going on for 2 weeks because of Oath of the Gatewatch.
Yeah, Oath of Gatewatch is going to be our bad format before Triple Champions. And Triple Champions just happens to take place during Magfest.
And then and then there's also and it goes on from there.
In early March we have Full Block, which will be fun to do. And then nothing really interesting until Triple Rav and then Full Block Rav. And then Triple Cold Snap is a treasure.
Triple Cold Snap is going to be something to show off.
It's going to be great. It's going to be... We'll vacillate over whether or not to start picking Snowlands or not.
Or we'll just pick every card with Surging. I'm going to do that.
No. We're going to see none of those. We're going to try to make a normal deck, and then we're going to lose round one every time because we fight the Surging Sentinels deck.
Nah, screw that. No, we're going to... Everyone's going to pick all the good Surging cards, and we'll get stuck with Surging Dementia, but we'll just play it as Mind Twist on two, so who cares?
That's fine. I like Mind Twist. I like Mind Sludge.
Yeah, Oath is currently like Betrayers of Zendikar.
Who said that? Oh, man. But yeah, what were you saying?
No, I was just saying, hey, Mike, the round ended, so we might not actually get to go very far with this.
Oh, he was going to shove some Momir at you.
He already shoved it in my face.
Make a one drop and then concede.
Keep. All right. Because, yeah, they're already done. We'll see. Make your one drop. Get your sigil. No, make a Glitter Fang. Show us Glitter Fang.
Glitter Fang with Sigil of Distinction. That's my call. Okay, Fire of Cavalry.
With Kite Shield.
And,
all right.
And Kite Shield. Okay. Okay, now we're getting the Glitter Fang with the Sigil of Distinction.
Well, then we'll attack. It's fine. Extort in a format with, like, spells over here. Ah! Yes! We got the better shield! Joke's on you.
Quarter shield, yes. Also, we get to, you could pay 2 life to remove a counter from target permanent.
That could be useful.
Yeah, like if they play a sigil, just, oh.
Oh,
I guess we're playing all of our swamps and islands. Hey, Angelic Page.
With Copper Carapace, so time to get our ass kicked.
True enough. Well, let's just... Wait, you played an island?
Yeah, I usually try to go for domain.
Well, I was thinking, since we have an extort creature in play...
Well, that won't matter until 4. And it can trigger off of the... It's not like you can trigger it multiple times. Yo, alright, cool.
Infiltration Lens? Nice.
Alright, anyway, moving on. So, this is what this looks like. I'm gonna go ahead and concede match.
Okay, when you said that, I still saw the other hand, which I think is a hand we have to keep.
Yeah.
Even though it can't pass the Woolshock Sorcerer.
There we go. Anyway, this hand freaking rules. Just want to point this one out. So back to the actual Magic.
Yeah, it's got Looter. Do we loot away Battered Golem?
Lightning.
No, we're not the Luxac. Amazing. Okay, we're not the Luxac. The guy who was playing Momir with him, Furry Gopher there, Mike, he is the actual Luxac, unless we're playing Diablo 3.
Alright, here we go.
Oh man, the bats!
Oh, jeez, I should have played that Blade Warden on 2, but actually, no, Thought Courier is better on 2 here. That's fine. Yeah,
because that's Lian and Bola, not Lian and Scimitar.
Yeah, if that was Bol, if it was the other. So here's the thing, I want them to tap out.
Yeah, if he taps out, we...
Oh, okay. Shit. And, oh, that's nope, he's going for it. All right.
Oh, okay. We take some damage and we punish him for it.
Sounds good to me.
Also, we can just tap down his unblockable guy if we want to.
Also, Battered Golem could just take care of that,
block
too.
It. Yeah, that's fear. What are we worried about?
Anyway, Volshock Sorcerer is here. I might discard that mountain.
Yeah, further mountains do not serve our purpose. Well, I guess we see what we draw first, because it's looting, which is good. Mm-hmm. I guess be wary of a Radiate, the first removal spell.
Yeah, I'm gonna get rid of mountain.
Yeah.
Whisper Silk Cloak, huh?
We could give our pinger... whatever. We'll just play our guy. Or do you want to... And our cloak can untap our guy.
Mm-hmm. So, do I want to equip that Bola, and who to is the question. Thought Courier?
Like, either of our creatures have tap ability. I guess we always want to use Volshock Sorcerer's tap ability. But we are okay not looting one turn if we... I don't know. I have no idea. Let's put it on the Thought Courier so we have a reason not to loot main phase.
I was thinking about putting it on the Thought Courier anyway, because it doesn't belong to any of the other creatures.
Yeah.
Irradiate me.
Do it! Oh. Okay.
Also, never attack with Volshock Sorcerer.
There's no reason to.
I'm glad that my opponent passed on 4. That's good.
Well, I've been known to do that. Pass on 4.
Third color.
That's everybody.
Essence Drain, killing off Thought Courier. Let's go ahead and get my last loot then.
We'll loot. Is a 5 mana removal spell. Alright. Yes. Do we attack with the Golem?
Likely. Especially if I, like... Yeah, we'll see.
We're probably just going to be playing the Cloak down.
Funnily enough, Cloak on the Golem is really bad.
Cloak on the Sorcerer is pretty okay, though.
Is my opponent going to let me resolve my loot, or what's going on? Also, he's not going to gain life. I hope you all realize that.
Oh, yeah, what's the actual card say? Oh, I know what's going to happen. Have you puzzled it out yet, friends?
Yeah. I'm going to discard that blue. And then...
And then...
And,
I guess he gains one life from this.
Better than 3.
It's better than 3.
Ooh, Trinket Mage. You're speaking my language.
That gets us an additional Golem on tap.
So I guess I'm going to attack and then do it?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, so... Because if I attack, then do it, and then...
Like equip the... Do we equip the Bola, or do we just, like, equip the... And what we get, which is probably, like, Bone Splitter?
Yeah.
Or, like, where do we want Lian and Scimitar at this point? I don't think we do. The power is more important due to the
I could
the
tap
play
Azdras
button.
Golem, but quite honestly, I'm fine with.
The trade. We trade our crappy creature for a sort of good creature. For an okay creature. Yeah. We have
We don't have. No,
Bolas.
we don't have Bolas. We have Bola, singular. The
Oh.
disciple of
Well,
Bola.
you know, I. Is it actually. I always thought it was. No, they are called Bolas. Because Bola means ball, and there's two of them.
Well, that's
So
nice. We get the Bola.
the actual thing is called a Bolas. It's called Bolas. It's like a pair of shoes. You have two of them. So you trip up the guy with the single ball on a string. Oh no, you get him with your bop it. No.
Oh, sweet. Okay, so he's taking the trade, which kind of rules.
That's okay, yeah. That lets us kind of dump our hand, I guess.
I'm gonna take
Are
that,
we.
yeah. So check this out. We're gonna dump our hand. Give me the Bone Splitter, and then give me Arc Blade Warden in play.
Yeah, so that next turn our Grey Ogre can attack for a lot.
Yeah, that's the idea. Wamu.
Who here is Wamu? I think it's Auroch Blade Warden. He looks the closest.
Look at my goddamn board.
Grey Ogre, 2 mana, 1/1, 3 mana, 1/1.
Nah. Double red, blue, white.
Look at your lands. You got perfect mana.
Yeah, that's how this works.
Easy
Ooh,
every
Conjurer's
time.
Bauble.
Ah, that does that, at least it
That
cantrips.
draws a
And
card.
he gets back his removal spell if he can shuffle his deck.
Yep, he's putting Essence Drain on the bottom of the library. So the other cool thing is that I don't know how much it affects him, but Voltshock Sorcerer, does. Okay, Echoing Decay. All right. So we're going to go ahead and. Wow. His hand must
He's
have a lot of creatures
one
that.
of those. Yeah, pinger required. Yeah, because he's killing that, not the Blade Warden. He saw us fetch the bone splitter.
Illaean Elder. Okay, sure.
Okay, we don't care. We attack right into that. What are their opponents red? Do they have the barbed lightning we didn't pick? Do you want to play Bone Splitter or play down a 5 mana 3/3?
Kind of want to get my board going.
We still get to attack with our Grey Ogre either way. A decent site to upload PDFs to. Slideshare used to be okay. I don't know if it is any longer. I haven't used it since I was in college.
Passing on the
Also, Google Docs, maybe?
passing up on the point of damage there to leave the Arc Blade Warden untapped, as my opponent did just show. Okay, all
A
right.
toughness-based removal.
Yeah.
Ah, he's got his own annoying elephant.
That's fair, I have a
We
tapper.
also, we can just attack with our tapper, maybe?
So check this out. We're gonna do like the sort of obvious play here. So he's gonna gain a
This
life.
is round two, game one.
So we're gonna do the equip to Arc Blade Warden and do the hyper play. Actually, kinda
You
wanna play.
could put the bolas on the trinket mage and then do the same thing with the 3/3 guy.
No, I wanna play the Whisper Silk Cloak here, I think. So I think I'm just going to attack with a Trinket Mage.
See what he does.
Yeah. Cause I wanna play the cloak. I wanna get that down.
Yeah, because then the. Well, no, that doesn't work with Auroch Blade Warden.
No, it doesn't. But I want to get down. See, the thing is, I put my opponent on 12. And then I'm going to put them on the 3.
Turn, we have an invincible 3/3 that can just attack.
Well, it's going to be more than that on the first attack.
Yeah.
Like you're gonna so we could put the bolas on the mystic. That's true. Mm-hmm. So tap your creature that's worthwhile. Two cards in hand. We're taking damage because he knows blockers don't matter. Nim Abomination. If Nim Abomination is untapped, you lose 3 life.
That's a fine card in terms of body. It does deal damage to him, though.
Yep.
Right, that's in our deck. That's a flyer, though.
Mm-hmm. So our opponent is going to take...
If we pump the Mystic, equip Bone Splinter on Mystic, equip Cloak on Mystic, that's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, then they die to their...
Well, their Abomination has to attack.
Right. Alright, that's an end step, not a bit upkeep, okay.
So anyway, let's do that, though. That sounds fine.
And then we can commit a 2-mana 1/1 flyer if we want to.
Which I will, quite easily.
Rocks are rhinos, and Loxodon are elephants, but you're right, they are both dogs. Crushing!
Now we need to play the Ghost, which gives us an out against Shatter. And we equip our Tapper, which I will likely use on Nim Abomination or something like that, just to prevent the most attack. In case of some crazy effect, I don't know. Oh, their own bolas!
Ah, that doesn't matter.
Yeah, I was gonna say, we attack for 5 unblockable here. So really not a lot that actually matters here. No point in showing our opponent anything else.
Not even our sword.
So, do they have a way to stop this? No.
What, an edict?
Yeah, so we go ahead and... Really, we had all of our colors come together. We had Volshock freaking Sorcerer show the hell up, and
we had a beautiful opening hand.
We did. We absolutely did.
So our Drooling Ogre or Regress worth considering? I'm guessing no.
Not really. I'm just gonna rock it. This deck. I wish it had more playable creatures, but I think every single person playing this format says exactly the same thing.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Oh. Here's a hand.
Rocket! I see Auroch Blade Warden, so... Oh, and Trinket Mage. Nice. Trinket Mage to go with Auroch Blade Warden's pretty good.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
I can't believe my not playing bolas is going to actually, matter here.
What, so we can maybe kill the guy?
We're going to kill the Blind Creeper on turn 4. It's going to be incredibly dumb, but it'll happen.
Right, because then we can go Gold Mirror, one mana thing. Chittering Rats.
Okay.
Plains?
Yeah, we just draw. It doesn't matter. We draw next turn.
That's what Chittering Rats does. That's a really good Gray Ogre.
Yeah. Yeah, let's go ahead and play the Gold Mirror. I am getting beat down here pretty hard though.
Yeah. He's gonna be attacking in.
Mm-hmm.
We could trade Gold Mirror for Chittering Rats if we felt like it.
But then I lose the...
Then we lose our mana. Yeah.
I'm going to just take 5.
Yeah.
We want to draw any land here.
Mm-hmm. And we can turn Gold Mirror... Oh, ooh, what's he killing?
Blade Warden? No, this is on Gold Mirror.
On our mana.
Alright. So yeah, this is gonna knock us back a little too far. And there's the... Oh, well, there's something real.
Yeah, we could just shock the guy if it becomes too much of a problem.
Yeah.
Could also play down bolas and just tap it.
I don't feel bad about that one either.
Also play down Trinket Mage as a to trade with the 3/3.
Let's do that threat.
Yeah, trade to the 3/3s each Chittering Rats.
Yeah. I like the threat. That's really all I'm after. And then use Trinket Mage, yes. And we're going to go ahead and grab Bone Splitter. And I am going to go ahead and play Bone Splitter on the turn.
Yeah, we would like to be able to use it next turn.
Sadly, him killing the land, like the land prevented me from being able to do the full gambit, but this is fine.
So now, do you think he takes the trade now, since after now it won't be a trade unless he has a removal spell for Blade Warden?
Yeah, I think he does. Mostly because of what you just said, like, the trade fails almost every other time.
Yeah. He's off his
Okay, no attacks, so he's completely out. A 3/3.
Interesting. And we can play the bolas and equip the... You can play the bolas or equip the axe, which I think we equip the axe.
Yeah, I equip the axe.
Yeah,
all of a sudden,
we have trained Harmadon.
Yeah. I'm also going to start attacking with Trinket Mage. Because this is a 2-2 currently.
Yeah, it's a 2-2. We're fine with either trade here.
We're not pumping because I'd like to have anti essence drain, anti removal spell, anti. Et cetera. Terror. Yeah, okay. That's fine. Terror's a good spell.
I just had a thought.
What's that?
If we had played the bolus instead of equipping...
He wouldn't have cast that terror.
He wouldn't have cast terror.
He would have cast terror in main phase.
He would have main phased it. That's all it did. Yep. Do we feel like trading?
Hell no, I've got instants. Check out how good my trade will be next turn. So I'm just going to go ahead and play and equip the bolas. I mean, I'm even going to leave up Barbed Lightning here.
That's fine.
Opponent's off colors.
Yeah, off colors. They could have 5 red cards in their hand.
Okay, so here's the part where I'm going to blow them out.
Yeah, here's our trick. Avast. A gray ogre. Or a grizzly bear. See, we were playing like we forgot to tap his guy with our bolas, but instead, we didn't.
Then we just crush on in.
Hooray for crushing!
Take advantage of our opponent being off colors. Great.
Wow.
Nice. Oh, hey, how's it going?
Hooray! Crushing.
We're gonna move that. The tapping.
Just in case.
The tapping is slightly more important, you know.
If he plays a blocker.
Like that.
Okay. Do you have another blocker? Okay. Yay!
Our opponent has a nice aggressive deck. Look at, like, you know, the creepers are quite good. He had that 3/4 that needs to attack. like
yeah, he had a good aggression with like removal spells.
Right, I like
of
our
varying quality.
Well, I wouldn't even say varying. Like, Essence
Echo
Drain.
Essence Drain's okay.
Yeah,
but Echoing Decay is good.
Yeah, this is just good, and then
Terror is also actually good, but not great again. But we had tricks.
We had Bone Splitter.
Also, you had Chittering Rats, and I love that card. Yeah,
Chittering Rats is really... So, like, I played a triple Darksteel draft once where I drafted, like, six champions of the card.
It's like, hey,
what if I
you
play
never
a
draw
a
card
that
ever
just
again.
Says you're never drawing a card ever again. Yeah, in the end, not playing the Bolas on turn one was a mistake. It was a mistake on one, and then he played the Blind Creeper, and it, like, double reverse became not a mistake, but it was a mistake. Like, there's no getting around that I just hit F6 without thinking. Because there are times that I just take my turn quickly.
If he didn't have the Chittering Rats there, his guy would have just died for free, which is cool at least.
Well, not either the Chittering Rats or the removal spell, but it's fine. I accept that I made the mistake and know that it happened. So
we're going right in.
Yeah, we're fighting Tusei _ Yawgmoth, who beat part-time Bard to get here.
I feel like I've seen that name before, Part-Time Bard.
Maybe. It's definitely possible.
Prizes are
refund.
Play points.
Yeah, let me click on prize structure and pull it up just so I know exactly what it is. Because, yeah, it's second place gets their money back, and first place gets double their money back and the QP.
It's also not a phantom draft, so we get to keep the crappy cards we picked.
Yeah, that's fine. Look, the real prize is we get to just keep doing this later in the future, which is always a prize, you know? It feeds into itself.
Yeah. This is a looter. Okay, great.
The QPs, if I have 15 QPs, I would be able to participate in a end of the month-ish qualifier event, the Magic Online Championship Series. I've only played in like one of those before, because I don't play enough to get to the 15.
So we got a looter. We're probably looting away the 2-3 on the ground.
Likely. The QPs reset every month. That's why we see a different planeswalker.
Yeah, that's why we have a bunch of different... And they don't, like, go away, right? Like, you keep them and they become worthless.
Yeah, basically.
You have a stockpile of Sorens.
Mm-hmm.
And winning one of those online events, doesn't that qualify you for something?
Something like at the end of the year.
I remember winning some of them was like letting, like, qualifying for some kind of paper event.
Yeah, it's a big event. It's just that, like, I'm not gonna...
Yeah, we don't care. or at least
I just don't like. I don't... The thing is, I end up with like, I have. I think I have like, you know, screw it. We're waiting for our opponent. You click, go click QPs. I think I have five Sorens, and I think we're on month after this week. We're going to be on season two anyway, so we'll stop seeing Sorens.
Yeah.
Anyway, I'm not going to forget to play this. Let's
watch
rock.
Bone Splitter. Bone Splitter is a great card, whereas Bola is just like a okay card.
Ooh. Ooh.
Behold.
The Bolas.
I think we're playing our looter down though.
Yeah.
Sorens, Karns. Ooh.
I can Trinket Mage for the final piece.
For our scimitar?
Yeah.
Yeah. And then...
Actually...
I'm gonna loot first.
No, because I'll draw it. 100%. I don't care if
100%.
It's 1. I don't care if it's 1 in 31, 100%.
You don't take unnecessary chances.
Also, I'm going to not attack because the loot on this hand is more valuable than 1 point of damage. If I equip the Bone Splitter, I would attack because 3 points of damage is enough for me to think that it's worth it.
We had a board enhancing card advantage. Ooh, Ferropede.
Ferropede can't be blocked.
Do we have counters on anything?
I don't think much, no. I'm going to discard the anchorite. Even with the land, still
yeah,
discarding
we
the
want
anchor.
Lands. Well, we know what we're looting, so...
Yeah, so anyway, I'm going to go ahead and let's make a giant trinket mage.
Yes, let's suit up our trinket mage.
Suit up, everybody.
Oh, we have, yeah, our Grey Ogre. Our Myrrh, our Sunburst Myrrh.
Yep.
He can, over the course of 3 turns, kill it.
Oh, yeah. Anyway, let's attack for 5. Also, here's some 1-mana artifacts. I don't know. Like...
Yeah, we got him.
And yes, I am going to Thought Courier, discarding the Thought Courier, unless my opponent kills the Thought Courier. But seeing as
or... We could possibly want another crappy creature in play in which to use our Bola with, but
yeah,
we're probably okay destroying our 2-mana 1/1 in our hand.
Yeah, because we already have a looter. All right, remove counter from target permanent. All right, cool. Counter removed. Yeah.
Counter removed. I like Ferropete's art a lot.
Ooh.
What's your replica? When are you going to pop that Waybearer's Bauble? Never.
Yeah, it doesn't look like that's coming anytime soon.
He's going to use it to make his Thought Cast cheaper.
So yeah, let's go ahead and discard the Thought Courier. I'm going to wait 1 turn to play Sky Under Patrol.
Yeah, we can fight past the wizard at that point. Behold!
So are they going to... So this isn't in the format, but I would laugh my head off if it was just like land turn to slag.
Wow. Yeah.
Luckily, that's a different Mirrodin.
That's different Mirrodin.
Mm-hmm.
With a worse, a better, but worse one. It's better because all the cards in it are way better. It's worse because it's got Infect, which is the worst mechanic in Magic.
Anyway, I'm getting attacked by a wizard replica.
Okay. Ferropede not coming in.
I'm also willing to tap his guy here. Like that one. I'm 100% willing to tap that right here instead of drawing the card.
Yeah. Well, we kind of like the card in our hand anyways.
Right, that's why I'm fine with that. So...
We did that... Oh, wow, okay. We kind of did that once, Retigo, where we did full Ravnica, like old Rav, new Rav. I don't think we did new Phyrexia, old, and Mirrodin, did we?
I don't know. I don't think so. Anyway, we're attacking. Ferropede is going to get in the way. It's fine.
Oh, Ferropede! No! He died before he could live.
And then it's time for Skyhunter Patrol to show up. Hello. 1 damage on Trinket Mage, so it is safe to move this equipment.
And now we have a 5/4 in the air.
Also, I'm going to loot away the Angel, because there's no way in hell that's resolving.
Yeah. Although if we draw a land, we could cast it.
I know.
If it resolved. It could be a large removal spell over Wizard Replica.
I guess if...
Maybe he taps out. Maybe. We'll see.
Yeah, we'll see. I'm probably going to loot anyway, because... The thing is that an actual card would be... Okay, Leon and Bola getting destroyed. All right. So Echoing Ruin is a really cool shatter. It's a sorcery speed shatter, but it's Echoing, which is, you know...
Pretty good.
Yeah, good. Yeah, so I'm gonna loot.
Wait, you never done any Mirrodin drafts? But you like Sunburst.
I'm gonna actually keep the Angel here, I think. Well, I don't
really. Over your 2-mana 1/1 flyer.
Yeah, that's sort of why. Mostly because I think my opponent's chump blocking with that Wizard Replica.
Yeah, let's see.
Ooh. That's gonna rock. So this behemoth does not fly. Just a heads up, you know.
It doesn't fly. Even if it did fly, it dies to first strike damage.
So let's go ahead and set up a...
Lethal?
Is that lethal? Is that...
No, the bolus is dead, so it's, it would be lethal if he did not have a flyer.
Anyway, our also, Blade Warden.
Yeah. The angel gets to live another turn in our hand before it gets looted, because you don't even have...
And here's the bobble pop.
Okay.
Maybe grabbing a fourth color, maybe just being... Yep, there's the fourth color. Ooh, we could be seeing Etched Oracle. Give me the Etched Oracle.
If he actually plays Etched Oracle, I'll be happy.
Same.
Because I like that card a lot.
Opaline Bracers. +4/+4 on the equip.
So Wizard Replica becomes large, but not big enough to block the Blade Warden powered Sky Hunter.
Correct, I will force a chump block.
Yeah. Then we loot here.
Discard mountain.
The wizard flies.
So, the trick is that I can go ahead and do that shenanigans I did earlier, where I go ahead and move the equipment over to the Blade Warden.
And this is better than playing the Angel, because it kills the Wizard, which means you can just play the Angel next turn if we want to.
Pump the Sky Hunter Patrol. And we move the... We move our equipment back over here. Mm-hmm. And we get to attack.
We have an Eldrazi.
We attack with our 9/8 flyer.
First strike.
Mm-hmm.
The wizard chumps.
Wizard gets in the way. And then I'm going to...
Trinket Mage picks up our swords.
It's not enough to matter. The Quicksilver Behemoth with the bracers. I'm going to... I don't think I'll do it. Actually,
No, we really don't need to, because we just attack with our flying creature next turn if he doesn't have a flying blocker.
Yeah.
And the Behemoth can attack once.
Well, then it bounces.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Yeah.
It can attack once.
So, opponent needs something. Rust Elemental. And Arcbound Stinger.
Flying blockers.
Okay.
So, he probably eats the Stinger next turn. Or does he eat the bracers?
Actually, I need to discard Razor Golem here.
Oh, you might just play the Angel this turn.
Yeah, I'm thinking the Angel this turn and then attacking.
Yeah, we can do both.
Hello! I got to play... Behold. I got to play 4/4 flyer.
We got to play our third pick or whatever.
Yeah.
What was our first pick again?
Bone Splitter.
Bone Splitter. Yeah, that card's won us plenty of games.
Yeah. Anyway, bye-bye Rust Elemental.
The Rust Elemental dies.
Well, of course, because he certainly didn't want to sack the Opaline Bracers, which is the only card he had legally he could have sacrificed. So now he gets a 5/5 flyer. The
that
problem
we attack
is,
into.
Yeah, the problem is I just attack into it with two flyers.
Yeah, and then
I didn't
see
even
if
loot.
He has a removal spell.
I did not even loot. See, this is what happens when I realize how powerful a position I'm in. I just, like, stop doing the correct thing, and I need to stop doing that.
Yeah, we probably should have, like, put the scimitar...
No, moving the equipment was not worth it there. Just looting was. That would have been the more proper thing, because I would have drawn into Barbed Lightning.
Ah, nice.
Yeah. So, anyway. So, yeah, I'm, again, just gonna say we rock what we rock.
Again, regress and... Actually... The ogre wouldn't be bad here. The ogre Leadfoot? But it's on our splash color, so let's not.
Look, this deck has performed well for 5 games running. We tune with the engine and it just all falls to shit.
Well, everybody's been playing stupid multicolor decks, which helped us.
I'm keeping this, sure. I don't even care that I'm off the color. I've got, like, a 2/2 for
me. Yeah, we have Windrake will save the day. And Island's on the top. Okay.
Certainly hope so.
Couldn't call the shot that time. At least now if we draw Volshock Sorcerer, we can cast it, which we will never see her. Oh, our opponent just won 2/3s. Where's their pancake, man?
Oh, sweet. Goldmere's really good here. Because it lets me play the Loxodon in my hand regardless of the draw next turn.
If we draw land, you mean?
No, 4 mana, Goldmere.
Oh, that's wrong Loxodon. I thought that was wrong 5 Loxodon. Mana, 3/3 Loxodon.
Nope, this is 4 mana, 2/3 Loxodon.
The Anchorite.
4-0 for 5 games? Yeah.
Like the, what's the anchor in the Anchorite? Is it that big vanity mirror he's holding?
Wait, is Anchorite like an ore?
It's what they make anchors out of on...
Yeah. Alright. If I get to attack...
Maybe 1 mana, 2 mana, 1 1, and 1, 2 mana, 1 1, go!
Yeah!
Let's attacking. I really want our opponent to hit 5 and then lead and blade trap our ass.
I think that'd be nifty. I'm waiting to get vexed.
You know, if you vexed the Anchorite, I would actually be okay with that.
Oh, echoing truth, the Anchorite. Uh-oh.
Wow, I'm in the step disperse.
Don's oh boy. Alright, his land now tap is a double.
So that's daily double.
Yeah, well, his land now is a double fertile growth on it.
Yeah.
Nope, this might be a steal the game with Razor Barrier type thing.
Yeah, it could be.
So, it is, adds 2 colors of any combination. So that's full power to any Sunburst.
Kevin all hollering about how our opponent's deck rules when they've done nothing for 5 turns.
They've literally done nothing for 5
cast,
turns.
They cast Disperse and Fertile Growth. And here we are without blue mana, I guess.
The thing is, the moment we draw blue mana, we get Trinket Mage for Bone Splitter for attacking for 4.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, what if our opponent just goes, like, Beacon of Tomorrows. Now, what if they make? What if they mind twist us?
I think it's like Opaline Bracers.
Yeah, that's what their top end was before.
Cobalt Golem. A 2/3 that gains flying.
A 2/3 that can jump.
A 2/3.
Do you want to just Zorch it down and attack?
Yeah, I'm even entwining it.
The mirror does more damage that way.
Mm-hmm.
He has his own razor barrier.
Oh. That would be good. I could have regenerated it.
Yeah, you could have sacrificed your welding jar that flies.
Hey, that welding jar that flies has done like 10 damage.
It's done 5 damage, and Leyden Scimitar has done 5 damage.
Yeah.
Actually, Leyden Scimitar is a good 1 mana 1/1.
Basically, if Cobalt Golem, if they had 7 mana and Cobalt Golem was their play, I don't think I'm really that scared of what's happening. You know?
His top needs something great.
Quicksilver, there it is. There's that behemoth.
Okay.
I'm just gonna fly over. I'm 1 short of lethal.
Yeah, 1 short. Which means we'll get their next turn.
Yeah. Because I could give this pro blue an attack for 4, but I can't get the gold mirror in.
Yeah.
And next turn I can move the scimitar onto the anchorite and attack for lethal.
I want our opponent to produce a lot of red mana and then cast larval. What's that guy called?
Larval. The 3-mana 7/6.
With trample that makes you destroy a bunch of lands.
Yeah, sack 2 lands every turn. Yeah.
I love that guy a lot because his art is amazing.
I remember playing against that. The first time I went to an FNM, I played a Shared Fate deck. In round 2, I played against an opponent who played a Cosmic Larva.
Cosmic Larva. That's what that card is
thank
called.
Thank you, Peach Millions, by the way. That was where I caught that.
Thank you, Peach Millions. I love that card. It's like this floating bubble that for some reason is like a 7/8.
Heliophile for 5.
Lava X. Okay, what does he actually hit with that? The flyer?
He's killing the flyer, which means I win.
Couldn't you give the flyer protection from artifacts?
Yeah, but I could give my Loxodon on anchorite protection from blue and attack next turn. I guess I could just attack all... It doesn't matter.
Yeah, either way, our opponent is tapped out.
So let's give it pro artifacts. Click on the circle for pro artifacts. And then the equipment falls off. And then we just tackle out.
It's attacking. We don't need blue mana to have a good time.
Yeah, we just have look, these are all blue cards, but they're here and we mold a 4.
Our opponent kept a land. He was like flooded or something. I don't know.
Yeah. Anyway, they kept a 6. So yeah. Welcome to this format.
We're undefeated in. No, we are defeated, but we're champions of this format.
Yep. I'm going to stand by my original. My original statement that I think this deck was really not good.
This deck was bad, but it was far more consistent than anything our opponents were doing, except for the black aggro guy.
Yeah, the black aggro guy had a plan.
He had a plan. He had some aggressive creatures, but his deck sort of petered out. I think we might be champions of Kamigawa because we've done some successful drafts of that before.
But this was it had 2 good equipments and an Arc Blade Warder. Okay, that Blade Warden. You know what? That's basically an excellent deck, right?
It lets you turn bad creatures into good creatures. So yes,
right. So. Thank you to this jalopy. That's a great word for it.
I enjoy that word a lot.
So do I. So we're good here.
It's good Mirrodin.
Good Mirrodin. So I think that's it for now. Thank you everybody for joining on this, and thanks to you Gnome for for hanging out in shotgun in the jalopy.
I have no problem with that.
Yeah, good place to be. So, good night, everybody.
Better than underneath it.